Jesus. Oh my god, my hair is a mess. Let's see if combing it'll help. Yeah. Yeah, I haven't showered today. I'm gonna shower before I go to bed, like, because I feel like shit. So yeah, but I'm streaming because I'm just in here anyway, so I might as well be streaming. And I'm building the chicken feeder as well. Oh. So I might as well stream it because I'm doing it anyway. So the only difference is I talk a bit more and I wear headphones. Oh, that needs sorting out. What the fuck? Oh no, that's right. Is that right? Yep. Certainly is. Bye. Sounds of silence. Well, apart from the chickens. I wonder if it's worth starting to save the XP from that. I might look at that one day. Because, I mean, there's a lot of XP there, you know. But it's a good few levels. Hi, Viking. And I've had Rihanna's Hey Mr. DJ bit stuck in my head. I have no idea why. So I've been like, hey, Mr. DJ or something. I don't even know the words. Just, yeah. And I'm cooking up. So I made some soul urns so I can make some concrete because I needed more for the trading. I've made, a dungeon for the villagers, if you haven't been checking Facebook. There we go, that's a nice stack of shit there for you. I need another, three pistons, that's perfect. That's how tall the chicken thing's gonna be, so it's gonna have a tall chimney-like structure. So that's gonna be good, because it's gonna add to the skyline. You've got the church, the windmill, that monstrosity. I mean, good monstrosity. And then you've got this as well, so it's gonna be canny. It's gonna look good. Well, hopefully it's going to look good. Hopefully I'll be able to make it look good, because there's a distinct danger that it could end up looking like arse. And I don't know how long the stream's going to last, because, yeah, feel like arse, so. But I thought it was important that I stream this because it's quite a technical build. Well, you know, quite a technical build. It's a technical build anyway, put it that way, so it's worth streaming. Because yena. Right, so how am I gonna do this anyway? Ah, oh, shit. Okay. Alright, yeah. They can alternate. Oh no, I'd rather them. Oh, they could alternate, I suppose. Oh, really? Really? Doesn't go over. I can't get it to go over. That's shit. I thought you could get it to go over these things. Alright, well, I think if I do this, if I put a block on top and it goes over the block, then that counts as powering it. See, that's the ladder to get up, so I have to kind of, I have to get up outside there, like that. Yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna. I was just thinking real quick. Stream should be loading. It should be fine. That should go there. Yeah, torches can go on there, so I guess that works. Right. If I on the other side. So three of them go in there, but that one obviously doesn't because it's not coming from that side. I'm wondering if it's all easier for them all, if them to alternate or not. So like I would have, these two, and then like, so I wouldn't have it here because then it alternates. That pulls back, and that pulls back as well. Well, it would do. I suppose that kind of makes sense because the melons then grow. So the melon can still grow if it's alternating, but if it's not, that's a good idea. Yeah, I'll alternate it, then it increases the possibility. The idea behind this is that these four dirt blocks can receive a melon, so like these five planters will have melon stalks in them. These dirt blocks were actually, you know what? I'll not explain it yet. I'll wait until I've hooked up the mechanical power, and that's another thing I'm gonna have to work out. Mechanical power. I mean, how big is this thing gonna be? That's the thing. I suppose I could. Yeah. I could just build a thing here. It's right under the tree. Maybe there. Wants to be like that. Let's see, like that maybe. Well, no, it wants to be where the chimney is, doesn't it? Five, that's five, okay. Bosh. I've made a load of what you call it as well. I've made a load of thingy bobs. hold on, let's just work out. Oh, that's not gonna go there, is it? Yeah, oh fucking bastards. I'm gonna need a screw pump. Oh, here come the squids. Come on then, you scumbag. That's right, you're trapped in there now, you're gonna get pushed out into that thing. Aye. Yeah? Aye, bugger. Oh, yeah. I actually need the die now. Right. Hi, Rip. So, screw pump. Or do I just move it closer to the water here and have it on a slant? Perhaps. Like. Yeah, I could do. I haven't even thought about the design for this building, to be honest. But it seems daft to not have it just closer to the water. So. Fit. Yeah, there it goes. Right, so that's turning. Alright, okay, here we go. Bugger off. Bloody squid, so I can hear you. Right. Right, so the power wants to go here. But do I want it to come through the floor? Do I want to make a feature of it as part of the building? Yeah, could do. I'll take it one block down, actually. Do I even want it on there? That's the question. What do I want this chicken thing to do as well? There's questions to be asked. Right, this is going to come down and feed the chickens in there. They're in the box. They're then going to lay, so their hopper needs to be powered. They're going to lay the chickens, the eggs, into a hopper, which then goes into the chest. No, it doesn't have to go into a chest. Nah, I'll make it. I'll just make it the hatcher. It can go into a double chest. Can it? Aye. Maybe in a multiple hopper room? Yeah, could do. I'm thinking of having it in a multiple hopper room where I can just have a load of hopper. It depends how many eggs it's going to produce, you know. But if it's automated, it's probably going to produce quite a few. Because the melons, I think, will grow quite quick. So these chickens are going to be constantly laying eggs by the end, I think. There's going to be chickens constantly laying eggs. I'm ill. San. Yeah, I'm ill with it's just a cold, but yeah, so I feel a bit shitty at the minute. But I'm streaming because I'm building this anyway, so I might as well be building it on camera, you know. Right, okay, so I think what I'll do is I'll make a full-on room with a lot of space for eggs to drop into hoppers. So I'll do it that way, right? So how am I gonna do it? That's a question. It's gonna have to go a little bit further down, which means I can probably just bring the. I can probably just bring it straight up here. Oh, hold on. Don't want to bring it up at face level, though. That's the question. No, I don't. I'll take it down. No, I'll take it down on the floor. I can always move it up. Right, so. And that's not going to work either, so. That work? Yeah. There's a lot of gearboxes I'm going through here. Oh, you know, come on. Come on. Too many. But tough shit. Sooner or later we're gonna have the pigman trap. And gold is gonna be a thing of the past. Oh shit, no, I didn't want to do that. Bosh, I want that there. There we go. Right, so this is gonna go all the way up there to the top, and it's gonna spin this turntable. It's on its slowest setting. So this is how it's gonna work. Oh. Oh, okay. Right, for one turn. None of there. Yeah, that's not good. That one. Okay. I don't want to step on this one that pulls away. Right, okay, well, let's see if I can mess with the redstone a bit. All four. Aye, there we go. That's better. Aye, so there's always at least two in there. So then what happens is the melons essentially grow. This is an auto melon farm, basically. So the melons will grow in there. In fact, I'm going to plant the seeds now so they can be growing, just to confirm that it will work. Because what if it doesn't? That'll be a shame, won't it? All right. Okay. So melon seeds. Okay, chickens. The weather is has been crap for me. Very, very windy. And rainy as well. Hi, Damien. Welcome. Oh, I'll be all right. It's just a cold. It's not, you know, it's nothing major. I mean, I called in sick for, I should have been working tonight. I called in sick because I just felt like shit. I'm a waiter, so it's not really very good for a waiter with a coughing fit. I've been having coughing fits today, like, you know, just coughing constantly. So it's no good really. So yeah, I called in sick, but I'm just sitting here playing games. I feel a bit like kind of woozy, lightheaded, groggy, you know, lack of energy. The standard, it's a standard cold, you know. There's nothing more to say than that really. But I'm building this because I'm just sitting here watching Sex and the City. Because I've watched The American Office like about five or six times, and I just recently finished it again, so I wanted something else to watch. Started watching Star Trek Next Generation. I'm halfway through season four, I think, and I was watching that a couple of times, but I was just like, I fancied something different. So, and I've seen Sex and the City before, and I watched it. I know I'm a guy, and guys aren't supposed to like it, but that's all right. So I've been watching that, and I just fancied streaming. Well, if I say I fancy streaming, I wasn't gonna bother, but then I was started building this, and I was like, I should probably stream it because people might want to actually see this. So, yeah. Right. So anyway, I'm gonna get rid of this. No, it's not the famous mesh cough. It's not whooping cough or anything. Right. Right, I'm going to mark the floor. Probably put that in there as well. That. I'll keep the gearboxes just in case. Don't have that red key. I'm going to mark the floor where these melons will be dropping out of. So, what, there? Is that right? Yeah, that is right, isn't it? Yeah, that's right. Okay, so the four melons will be dropping there. And then the hopper is going to be here, where the chickens are. Ah, oh, for fuck's sake. I've done it wrong. Shit. They needed to be on the diagonal. How does that even work? They need to be on the diagonal. So, like, fuck. I'm gonna have to rewire all that up there. So the hopper would be here. The things would be here as well, because walls need to be up here, obviously, to keep the chickens in. So the seeds would land on the diagonals. So that means the pistons... The piston will go let's see, I'll mark that with where the piston would go. Piston would go here and here, here and here, to pull it out, which means that's where the hopper will go. That's where the walls are. That's where the dirt. Well, that doesn't make sense. Actually, you know what? Just for ease, just so I know what I'm doing. Right. Okay. So the dirt is the dirt, for obvious reasons. So the pistons is the jungle wood. They pull the dirt out. Those two will put no. Probably alternate either side, because yeah. And then the cobble is a planter, so you'd have one there, one there, one there, and one there. So you'd have you'd have all the planters on that side. So you still have three planters on each side. It's just they're going to be in different locations. So that's going to have to be how it's done. Yep, I'm going to have to redo it up the top. Back in shame. Right, so I'm going to need more. I'm going to need six. Was that six planters? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 planters, okay. I've made a load of stuff today, like little ingredients and things like that I need. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I need two more. Bals. It's all right. It's all part of the process. I should have built it on the ground before. Still only need four pistons. Alternating the pistons is the question, though. In fact, I'm going to need more seeds as well, because I'm going to have to tear those planters up. Bring brown, 12 over. I haven't had a continuous cough. Don't be daft. I've only just gotten ill the last couple of days. I've not been ill this year at all. I had a cough for a long time back a couple of years ago, where I had whooping cough, but that was a specific cough. It's not just like me coughing. Right, okay. Alright, so. Ah, shit, I'm gonna have to just. And I'm definitely gonna turn this off as well, because. I did bring a lever. I knew there was a reason why I brought a lever. There we go. Right. Right, okay. Right, pistons go on this side. Right, okay, so that's in the middle there. These are on the sides. Like that. I'm gonna just fill that in for now, just so I'm not being a total spaz. Spaz lols. Oh. Safety as well. Let's pick up these. What do you call it? Ah, exactly. What? Nah, it wasn't hilarious. It was horrible. Alright. Four pistons. Okay. Let's put these in place. Right. Does it, no, I want them to come out the sides of here. Aye. Ah, fuck off. Right. I don't want too much circuitry up here because I don't want it to lag too much. These are going to be planters. Well, I'm going to put the planters in now. So, So, planter. Oh, for fuck's sake, you've got to be kidding. Oh, fuck it. I'm not even. That's where the turntable is. I should have moved them all across by one. Oh, I could do that, couldn't I? I'll put it here. Oh, for fuck's sake. It is, are you shitting me? Are you actually shitting me? Right, okay, let's get rid of them. I'm having a nightmare now, like. Things, and then there, and then there. Is that even right? No. Why am I finding this so difficult? Why? Why am I finding this so difficult? It was here. Hang on, what was going on there? It was there, wasn't it? Oh, aye, because they're not. Yeah, they're not on the side of that. They're on there. There. Oh, why haven't I not got any more cobble? Fuck! Right, so you've got the dirt there. You've got the planter and the planter. The planter should be there, though. Why am I... What? What's going on? What have I done here? What am I doing? What's going on? This is so confusing. Oh, fucking hell. Right, okay. I haven't even got any more fucking cobble. Are you kidding me? I'm not going to run around and scrounge up this stuff. But I am, because I'm obviously doing it right now. Right, okay, never mind. Right, fuck it. I'm going to go get some another static cobble. Right, okay, we're gone. This is the time. Right. So the dirt is going to be not there. It's going to be here. Boosh, boosh, boosh. Here we're gone. Right, okay, so... The pistons are going to go from that side. That's going to be a planter. Obviously, that is that. Yeah, that'll work. Yeah, I think that'll still work. I have to put some cobble on the end there. I think this will work. I'm going to put the planters in. Nope. That. Fuck. Fucking hell, man. Fuck. Jesus. Yeah, you'll have to get over that, Viking. It's done, man. It's in the past. It wasn't even that, like... the footage, like, it wasn't even, like, amazing. Because a lot of the scares had kind of gone. Towards the end. Yeah. Right, pistons. I'm gonna have to get rid of this. Right, and that. And that. There. And. Nope. It's going there anyway, isn't it? Yep. In there. Ah! Oh god, that's making me twitch. Fuck! Gonna pick it up. Come on. Yes. Finally. Something good happened. Right. Fill that in. Fill that in. There. Okay. Good. Now. That and then um, There. So they're all those dirts are surrounded by planters, apart from that one. There. Now though, all the dirts are surrounded by planters and cobblies. Right, now let's see. So we can't alternate them now by using the turntable. Can we? No. Nope. 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 Would have to do... I didn't want to do that. I didn't want to do that at all. No. They either all come up or they all don't come up. Oh, I'm having a nightmare. Seriously, this is bad news. I need the turntable moving back. I need this whole thing moving to the left one block. It's like I'm moving the whole thing like by one and then one and then one. Dismantle it. I need to move it along by one because I can't. Can I? Is there any way I can do that? Oh, there might be a way I can do it. Nope, there's not. What am I thinking? Of course there's not. And that's there, everything's there. Right, I'm not moving this. I'm moving this. Fuck it. I'm moving this one block across. Screw it. Screw it. That's it. And then I save. No, I don't. No, I don't. Oh, yeah. Okay, I want to put the turntable in first. Windy wind. Be there, I think. Put that there. Jesus Christ. I knew that would happen at some point. What a girly yelp. That was the best girly yelp I've ever done. Right. Is this working? It certainly is. Right, okay. Yeah, it's a long time. I think the best thing to do is probably this. Yeah, hold on. Oh, shit. No, don't think I want that. No, I don't want that. I want that's faster. I don't want all of them in. See how slow this is. That's a bit better. Hi, Brownie. Right, the question is there any way of... Well, of course there is. I can alternate each one individually. I just didn't like the idea of using NOT gates because every circuit I put, it increases the lag, really. If I can even... Oops. Well, all right. So I can do that. Yeah, I can do that. That means there's always the two on there. If there's two there, then it means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's five can grow. And then there's two there, there's five can grow. If there's two in here, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 can grow. So this is why I've done this. This is why I've inverted the signal. If I don't, these two are in when these two aren't, right? And when the dirt's there, that means that every tick, there's a chance for obviously the melon to grow. Now, each one has its own individual ticking system, I'm assuming. So with that in place, there's three chances on every tick for a melon to grow, okay? Now, if they're both in, this one shares between them two. So there's technically only five chances for a melon to grow at any one time. But by inverting these signals, there's now six chances for a melon to grow at any one time. Because you've got those three and these three. Just increases the output. By putting those NOT gates in there, it increases the output by a certain percentage. Like, I don't know, 20% or something. Increases the chance of a melon growing by 20%. Technically, I suppose it's not true, but it doesn't matter. It's just I'll leave it like that for now and see what happens. I'm going to remove these, all the superfluous cobble that I don't need. Bosh. I mean, I might as well leave that up there because I'm gonna want to build a building around this, like a nice looking thing. It's gonna have to incorporate that on the side, so I'm gonna have to build it out here by one. So yeah. Anyway, I'm gonna plant the seeds so they can be growing. Just to make sure that's gonna be fine. Obviously, I want torches there. It's not gonna matter once I've. It's not going to matter once they've grown. Actually, I don't know if it does. I don't know if light level influences it, but I'm already getting a little bit of lag by being up here. I don't know what goes on with my computer here, but I get a little bit of a stutter every time the pistons push. So I'm hoping that's not going to happen when I'm down there. No, this isn't a melon farm. It's a chicken auto feeder. Oh, I do. I'm lagging when I'm up here because I can hear it. I think it's the sound. I'm going to go over here. Yeah, I lag a bit. I might have to completely abandon this project because I can't have those pistons running all the time. My frame rate's already starting to go a bit weird. Like, I get 42 FPS when I look in that direction, 45 FPS. It's crazy. No one else gets this problem. No one else who I've ever played Minecraft with, no one else who've ever played on the server or anything, no one gets a performance hit when pistons push, when a simple circuit like that, and with the kiln and the crucible and pretty much anything that happens. The chicken feeder, I get lag when it activates. Not the chicken feeder, the egg hatcher. Everything lags me, and I don't know why. My CPU's not that bad. My graphics card's great. Everything is fine. I don't understand why it lags. I'm not sure. Sorry, Brownie, you didn't know. I mean, it's in the title's in the title's there, actually. It does say chicken auto feeder. But, you know, whatever. Doesn't matter. Yeah. It's annoying. Tempted to set it up on an item decay timer instead, so it's not. And that's a thick chimney as well. Yeah. Tempted to set up an item decay timer. This is lag. I mean, you won't be able to see it, but I am lagging here, like. Fucking sucky. Really bad. I mean, I even turn off the crucible when I'm not using it. You're fucking joking, right? What the fuck's going on here? Shame. Hi, Morgan. Yeah, temper to an item decay timer, which would technically mean I'd still need mechanical power because I'd want to power the hopper underneath the chickens. I wonder if I would get more lag less lag if I do the inverse. To both pull. That's a bit less. That's less lag, you know. I think it is. This is just my imagination. There's still a bit of a twitch. Bit of a twitch. I'm just wondering whether I want that every couple of seconds, or if I do an item decay timer, I can do it every 5 minutes. You know, so every 5 minutes there'll be a twitch rather than every few seconds, which might be a better idea. So I'll see. I'm gonna have to wait for those to grow, I think, before I do it, because I want to see how effective it is. Like, if they grow quick. Because if I do an item decay time that's every 5 minutes, then it's not going to be anywhere near as productive. Anyway, while you guys are on, I'll show you the dungeon. I'm going to gonna stick these in this box just while I'm waiting for them to grow. I'll wait for them to grow. I'll take this up because I don't need this anymore. Why is there no torch on there? This all needs sorting out as well. I'm hoping that this building will tie this area together a bit, and I can make it look a bit nicer outside. A couple of little bushes and stuff, because this area's woefully been needing, a building there for a start, and also just a bit of infrastructure in general, to tie it together to make it seem like an actual coherent part of the town. And it's the last part of the town that really needs it. Yeah, I think it is the last part of the town that really needs it, and then I can start expanding the town a bit more, because this is just dead space. It's horrible. It's gonna have like a square here with a path. I might replace these paths to something a bit more structured. I don't know, but I do like this kind of idea of the path. But I need more than that building. I think I'll have that building there, but I think I might have to have another building here, like maybe a little farm building for this wheat. I don't know. Anyway, we'll see the dungeon and the church. Yeah. Why is that door open? Is that door open? It's not, is it? I'm panicking now. I'm paranoid about the church now. Not least because all my priests are now in here, which isn't a good thing. So if something goes wrong, then they all die. So yeah, I've got the priests here. Which I brought them over. They're level 2 at the minute. They wanted an enchanting table to get level 2. Couldn't believe it. Anyway, down here is where the dungeon is. Dun dun dun! This is what I spent a day building. I've got all my villagers from over at the farm over here. So, like, you got a blacksmith, the two butchers here, you got another blacksmith there, and then the two priests from the other side. That's an empty space at the minute. Oh, you've got to be fucking kidding. He fucking suffocated, didn't he? That little cunt. That little fucking cunt suffocated. I fucking hate them. Fucking villagers, that was my last diamond. I've got two diamond. Nah, that was my last two diamond. Little fucking bastard. I fucking hate these villagers. I fucking hate them, I really do. You fucking bastards. So he suffocated then, cunt. Seriously, I'm pissed off now. Like, it's a waste of two diamonds. It's a waste of two fucking diamonds. What a load of shit. So annoying. Right, okay. Well, anyway, I'll have to get two more diamonds. I think I might trade some with Ethan. Ethan was talking about trading some diamonds. I've just got ingots now. I've got two more diamond gems, but I need one of them to lead the villagers, to make them followers. So yeah, I can't use them at the minute. So I'm gonna have to trade some with Ethan. Ethan was wanting vine traps, I think, so I'm gonna have to trade some of them with him. Hi, how dare he? Oh, some eggs. I think I'll go and hatch these. I hatched a stack and a half of feathers before. It took, almost, I'd say 50% more than these eggs. I got a stack and a half of feathers, so I was quite pleased with that. So I'm going to go hatch these ones. I could have done, I suppose. What have you got? Nothing. Okay. On the path back from Communal, I ran into a zombie on the bridge over that little chasm. So I'm going to make that bridge look a bit better and a bit safer. Because I nearly fell off. And then when I backed up over the bridge while he was coming at us, a creeper behind us exploded. So I was in the dark and I had to kill the zombie because I was running in the dark. And I had to kill a zombie, so I just managed to kill him by to repair the hole in the ground, but I was on half health, I think. He was here. and this bit blew up. So I was like, ah! That's what happened. Train tracks need making. Loads of stuff that needs doing. Fuck off, Skelly. Go. I love watching this. It's great. Come on, hatch some eggs. Are you kidding me? Are you actually shitting? Where's all the chickens? Ah, that's right. Come on, spit them out. Fucking hell. That is ridiculous. Right, so you put a sign there when you've hatched some, so anyone else that comes to use it could say, oh, it's Mesh's feathers, right, so you come down here, and you check the box, and you're like, right, okay, his feathers can go in that box there, or this box here, or whatever, you know. Because it's a communal thing, this, so you got to be aware of things like that. So anyway, I'll leave them to grow up. I'm going to hide these eggs in the communal cauldron, because, I mean, they... It's free food, so why the hell not? Of course it rains. Hey, Stormcrow. Oh, a lot of my trees have grown. I planted like 200 odd trees out along the river. You know, the river that we take to get out of our, well, our river that we take to get out to the sea. Well, I planted a load of trees all around the area, and loads of them have grown. Like all these kind of trees here. Look, they're all, I've got loads of saplings all over here, everywhere. And they're all growing. So that the river's going to look a bit nicer. My aim is to make this plains into a forest, essentially. So, yeah, I planted them all the way along there. As far as you can see, really, all the way around. There's loads all the way around there. There's a few all the way around here. And I'm going to plant some more to fill the gap. And this whole area is just going to be forest. It's going to be like, yeah. I like the forest, I do. It's great shit. And then what I'll do is I'll run through and put torches on every tree like this. So it'll be a way of lighting up the surrounding area to make our trap more productive. But without it having torches all over the floor. Torches on trees, I don't mind. I actually think that looks fine. It's definitely the best of a bad situation. So I'm happy with that. So yeah, if I get some trees, I can just... I don't think I need to harvest these. This is my mycelium farm as well. I don't know if anyone saw it. But I planted it. It looks more natural, but I like it. Well, that's kind of why I like it. Oh yeah, I forgot I'd put some axes in there. Pardon me. So there you go. Speaking of Java, I installed Java 7 and I'm running the game with Java 7 now and I haven't had a crash since. So Java 8 sucks, everybody. Java 8 sucks ass. How are these doing? Oh yeah, one's grown. Come on, grow, grow, Grow a melon. Grow a melon. I'm going to stand here until it grows a melon. No, I'm not. I'm not. I'm going to wait for them all to grow. I'll be interested to see how quickly it produces a melon. We'll know because the seeds will be all over the floor when they start dropping. I hope it works. Anyway, let's do a bit of farming and general upkeep and maintenance. Yeah, I'm definitely getting some lag. Like, I might just have to restart my computer. Like, but yeah. I also ground up a boatload of netherrack as well. I went to the I don't remember going to the nether. Like, I must have gone and collected a load of netherrack. But I ground all that up and I've put it in me solar and bottling room. Ready to bottle more. I used a bit of it to bottle some more souls. I made a stack of soul urns. A stack of urns, and I made some soul urns. Because I needed them for... don't know why. Why do I need soul urns? Oh, concrete. I need to make some more concrete to trade with the villagers. So I did that. But I also need some ghast tears. So yeah, I might go out in the nether and hatch some for the lols. Hi Ralph. This is the chicken feeder morgue, yeah. Yeah, it's the auto chicken feeder, but I'm getting lag from it. So I'm kind of debating whether or not to replace the mechanical power with an item decay timer. Which would obviously involve me having to fill the item decay dispenser. But I'm wondering if that's just a better thing to do. So, I don't know. I mean... mechanical power is good in theory, but you know, it's whether or not it's a viable method because of how laggy it might be. So you got to think about that. It's a shame you have to consider lag when you think about stuff like that. I could trade these. I could trade all them. 7 emeralds. 8 emeralds. Okay, so 15 emeralds I need. I think I did a bit of trading before. I want to level those priests up. Oh, yeah. I'll do the whole lot. I'll do all the trades. All the trades. Let's get me diamond oot. Right, what do they need? Legs and a sword. Well, pixies. Okay. Legs and a sword. Right, that's, what's that? 7, 8, 9 ingots? 5, okay. Well, I don't need them. Melt them down. Ahem. I've got no food. Brilliant. Well, exactly. I need to level them up though, because we can't go to the end without leveling them up. Yeah, I called sick. I didn't go in. I'm there. Yeah, I'm coughing. I keep getting coughing fits and stuff. So, I know from experience working as a waiter with a cold is just crap, because I feel embarrassed for the fact that I'm coughing my guts up. So I try and hide it by not coughing, and then I end up, when you hold in a cough, it's not a good experience. You end up sweating because you're just like, "What did you want there? Oh yeah, you wanted some chips. That's great." And yeah, it's not fun. Ah, oh, only one. Ah, balls. Have we got a crappy diamond sword somewhere? No, they've got good enchants on them. That's a good one for the spiders. Oh, that's another thing. I expanded the spider, the spider trap in the jungle. I almost doubled its capacity, so we'll see if it's made a difference. Me and Sticks also went extensively caving underneath the jungle to light up as many caves as we could. We went through 12 stacks of torches, and we still had more to light up. We found a what you call it as well. A thingy man. One of those mine shafts, that's what we found. So, yeah, pretty special times. An axe. Yes, please. I'll have that enchant for the measly price of 3 emeralds. Defos. Oh, yeah, and I'll do that as well. Right, time to melt this down. Make another axe. Brilliant. I'll definitely have that. You know what? I've been trying to get that enchant, efficiency 3, unbreaking 3, because I know my axe is halfway down. I've been thinking I want another axe after that one goes. And lo and behold, the enchanter comes up, trumps the priest. Legend. He can touch as many kids as he wants if he's gonna give us enchants like that. Sweet Jesus. And spluttering, obviously. Yeah, I don't want to be spluttering over everyone's food. Oh, and I've got face ache as well, a little bit. You just feel like that. And I'm aching. And I think this morning I twisted a muscle in my back as well when I woke up. Oh, a bit painful. It's good times. Right, okay, I need to make a sword, I think. I should have taken one of those axes, because is that axe there? Well, I'll keep the unbreaking 2, efficiency 2 of each item. No, it wasn't so hard. No, it was just I got when I got up. I'm not going this way. It's just when I got up today, I stretched in bed, I think, and I just it just pulled. It takes absolutely no strain at all to just pull this muscle the way it is. There's two muscles I've got: one in me upper back, right between my shoulder blades, and then one in my neck, around there, that I pull now and then. And it's excruciating. Well, there's two modes basically. I'm finding out that there's essentially two modes. One, it doesn't hurt that much, and that's what I've done. It's like stage one. Stage one, I'm in at the minute, and it's all right. But if while it's like this, I then pull it again, I go to stage two, which is agony. It's agony. It really is. It's fucking horrible. So yeah, I'm hoping that doesn't happen. Hey, come on, eh? This guy with the enchants, eh? Fuck. Look at him go. Bringing out the big guns tonight. Right, well, I'll make this sword and get that enchant done. Oh, Okay. Right, that can be melted down. Right, I'm going to see flint and steel. Yeah, this is where I get some emeralds back. Come on. Give us some emeralds back, bitch. Taking all my emeralds with you, with your crap. Right, there we go. That's right. That's right, you dirty slut. Okay, gotta wait for him. Right, he's doing that diamond pick, and I can do this trade now, which will level him up, so I'm definitely gonna do that. What's the efficiency? Crap. Okay. What's that? Oh, efficiency 2 and breaking 2. Well, I might as well just... No, I'll not. I'll make another one. Because what's the point in doing that, right? I'm just going to chuck this away. I wouldn't do that if it didn't level him up, like... Ugh. Well, that's good, because it's efficiency 3 at least. I could replace this one with that, I guess, and level him up again. A painting for 3 emeralds? Bargain, mate. Bargain. Yeah. Made you choke on a starburst. Why? Oh, because I said you can touch as many kids as you want. Is that what I said? I can't remember. I can't remember what I said. I'm speaking shit, man. I don't know what I'm saying half the time. I do have chocolate though, which is debatable whether or not I should be eating it. It's not debatable at all, I shouldn't be, but Galaxy bubbles. Basically Aero or Whisper. Cadbury's equivalent. Whisper is Galaxy Bubbles is basically Galaxy's take on a Cadbury's Whisper or Nestle's Aero. Oh, yeah. Hi, Damarian. Oh, I was going to say Damien. Right, what we've got here. Okay, so I'll phrase that because I got those 3 emeralds. No, I'm not. I'll trade that. I'll trade them both, actually. No, I need 4 emeralds. Come on, what are you going to give us? Oh, aye, that's it. Hemp. Shit. Okay. They're both going to level them up, though, so it's a small price to pay in emeralds. I mean, they're quite cheap, these enchants. And it's not like that. I mean, the diamond and the iron is free. So it's just the emerald cost, so paying 2 emeralds to level them up is a worthwhile trade. And that one's a worthwhile trade because it's a good enchant, and so is that one. So I'll make these ones, for sure. I prefer chewy sweets. I do. So yeah, diamonds players, that sounds like sarcasm. I am not on top form tonight, this is shit commentary. I don't mind admitting that, because I'm full of cold, I'm full of flu, but there's no more nice trades to be done here tonight, so I'm going to take my diamond and I'm going to go. I'll make some more emerald elsewhere. I can check the dungeon though, because these guys, I might work on leveling these up a bit. Not the blacksmiths, because they're just backups. The blacksmiths are purely here for backup purposes. I ain't leveling them up because they cost a fortune to level up. Ooh, you see, I can get emeralds down here. I mean, obviously I could remove that because that's 9 emeralds, but hey. Let's not be animals, you know what I mean? Let's not be animals. Right, hi mate. You want a picture, yeah? That'd be 3 emeralds. Oh, you want another one? Aye. My pleasure. And hemp. Oh God, I'm. Oh, here we go. This is where I get my emeralds down in the dungeon. Alright, let's bring a few of these, a few of that, a few of them. Let's go back down here. I've got what you need. I got what you need. Yep. But now he's gonna want an enchanting table, which I don't know if I like the idea of, to be honest. Oh, this is perfect. You know what I'm just thinking? These early trades are so easy because all they ask for is either mushrooms, hemp, or paintings. Have you noticed that? Up until they reach the end of level one, he's asking for hemp now, right? Here we go. What is that for next? Next, more hemp, and now obviously he wants the enchanting table. But up until level one, I can get a few emeralds out of him. So I'm wondering if it's worth the 2 diamonds in return for the all the emeralds I'm going to get. Because I mean, I don't know how many emeralds I just had then. Does anyone remember? I think I had 2 or something. Didn't I trade some with him? Some with him. So I got like basically about 6 emeralds from each of those guys there. So it's essentially, if you think about it, swapping 2 diamond for 6 emeralds. It's not worth it, is it? Now, the librarians, I've heard they're good. They're a good source of emeralds. Because paper, I mean, I've got paper coming out my arse. Actually, that doesn't. No, I don't like that idea. Haribo's good. I could do with some Haribo right now, like some Starmix. Oh yeah, or some of the bears. I've got 24-hour garage. I could go and get some. But because I'm ill, I'm not at the gym, so I'd kind of feel a bit, well, not guilty, but guilty. Like, I shouldn't be eating these. Right, 15 emeralds though. You know what that means? More trading with these bastards. Right, I'm gonna swap this one. I'm just gonna put that straight in there and just swap it out straight off for an efficiency 3. And then I'm gonna do my diamond. I'm gonna get a diamond pick. I'm gonna make one. All right, lads, let's go home. I ain't dying for these bastards. There we go. He's ready to go to 3. And what does he want again? Yeah, fucking bastard. Yeah, vessel of the dragon. Pals, that's my sex dungeon. Yeah, that's exactly what it is. No, I don't know Vanos. I'm not doing it. I'm not playing G mod either. Well, the sour ones are all right, but I can feel my teeth melting when I eat the sour ones. Let's get this back out because there might be a couple of more trades here. That's the thing. If I just keep him perpetually, oh no, because he starts asking for, yeah, there it is. That's not a bad enchant, actually. And what do you want, scumbag? It's not even a good enchant, prick. I'm not replacing that one with it. Have I got? No, I haven't. Okay. Let's put them back in there. We'll take our spoils, and we'll head back home. Right, so that's a worthwhile axe, and this one's a worthwhile one as well, but it only has efficiency 3 on it, not the unbreaking, which is a shame, but I can live with that. Smite 1 needs to be melted down, and that can go in there. Let's melt this shit. Might as well pick up all these. Bye, Demarion. Let's check out, see if there's any melons growing. Damn, no seeds. That's a bit concerning. There should be some by now. Well, the stalks are there, some of them. Come on, grow. Well, if this, I mean, this, well, technically, this is a good thing because if it's going to take them a while to grow, then it might be best just to have the item decay timer pull them out every 5 minutes. So, G mod is gay mod. Well, that's fair enough. But what's wrong with being gay? That's the question. That's the question. I mean, you don't even know me. What if I am gay? I mean, that's a highly offensive thing to say, isn't it? I mean, what if I like men's bums? You know, it's stranger things have happened, you know. There are people out there that like men's bums, you know. Right. No, I'm not from Ireland. I'm from England, but yeah, a lot of people do actually mistake me for an Irish person. But I'm from the northeast of England. Right, 2. Put that back in there. Right, that was some good trading with those guys. Let's see what the blacksmiths have to offer. Because I can't remember. Oh, 5 gold nuggets, gold ingots. That'll be an easy trade once we get the nether set up. 10 emeralds. I could do that trade, you know. I could do it. Get some diamond boots. Oh, have we got any emeralds in there? No? No, we haven't. I'll do that trade, I think. Because, I mean, you know, we're running a bit low on diamonds. Right, 10 emeralds for diamond boots. I didn't need anything else, did I? I just need to give them. Whoop. Oh, that's not him I want to level up, though. It's this guy, because he's... Oh, he's 4. He's only 3. I'll give them to him instead. That's the same boot, isn't it? 41. Hang on. 4. 4 ingots worth of diamond. 4 ingots for 10 emeralds. That's nice. That's almost... what's that? 2.25 emeralds per... Isn't it? 10? No. 2.5. Ah, it's 2.5 emeralds per ingot. Whereas that, 7 into 41. Anybody? I don't know. That's more than... 7 times 2.5 is... 18. That's like... That's really expensive. Jesus Christ. What's the other end? Oh, here we go. Mining charges. This is the big guns. Shit. This is the big guns. God, this guy's hard to level up. I wonder what he must. He'll want to. Am I a cracked user? No. A crack user. Oh, you mean. Yeah, you mean meth. Is that what you mean? Nope, I'll remove that message because you're not allowed to advertise your server here. Hi, Michaela. Welcome back. That's alright, everyone has lives. Well, most people do, so you can be forgiven. Am I a cracked user then? No. A crack. Do you mean am I using a cracked version of the game? No, this is a multiplayer server. No one else is online, so technically I'm single playing right now. But it is a multiplayer server. I'm going to pop these back in the boxes and I'm going to see about... see if these farmers have grown up. And if they've suffocated as well, I am going to kick... off. Right, let's go the long way because we'll see if any melons have dropped yet. Oh yeah, no, I'm not a free user. You mean a pirate? You mean a filthy thief? Is that what you mean? Is that what you're asking me? No, I'm not. I bought the game a long time ago. Come on. Why has this one grown much? Once they all grow. I mean, they're all grown. These are all fully grown, so that one should get a melon on it. I wonder why it's not doing it. I think what... No, you know what? I think what we should do, because it's taken ages to grow, I think we should move this. Watch. Hold on. There, like that. And they all move at the same time. That's like that. That's better. And we'll slow it down as well. There, so we'll slow it. So they're in. No. Add on. No, we don't want to do that. We want them all on. All the time. So, not all the time. We want another redstone torch. Gives them more of an opportunity to grow, because I figured they'd be growing faster than that, and they're really not. So, we'll put another redstone torch up there. And this will allow the dirt to stay there for longer. There. So, it'll stay there for three turns. Because there's three torches. There's only one... Hold on. What? Oh, bugger. What? Ah. Hello, what's going on? Is... okay. Now what I want is I want the turntable here where it originally was. But that's all right. I can correct that with a little bit of loving. And we'll put that there. By loving, I mean redstone, obviously. Right, okay. Let's get down here. Get a bit of redstone. It's a private server. It's not a cracked server, no. It's a legit server. I rent it from a server hosting company called Fragnet. And a lot of you have probably heard of it because they're quite popular. They're quite popular servers. Right, here we go. Right, this is how I'm going to do it. This is how shit's going to get done. In fact... I might have to expand this. I mean, if this ends up being the right thing, then I'm going to do it properly. I'm just experimenting right now. Bugger. I want... this might not work very well. There. Bosh. Pulled out. And then back in. And it stays in for quite a while. And then pulls out. Yeah. That's... Yeah, that's good. Okay. That's right. Mesh, I always liked you because you are so nice. More things that I could tell you, you're nice. I just want to say that because you know it is a lot of reasons. Okay, thanks. I appreciate being called nice. Daryl, I see. Wait. What? What the hell's going on? What is this? Where is Daryl even in? Right, I'm gonna leave that there anyway, and then hopefully, hopefully they're gonna grow. And I'll get to see how fast they grow, I suppose, once all the stalks are done. I'm quite surprised at none of them growing. Like, I've never really stood and trying to watch a melon grow. Yeah, I've never really done that, so guess they take longer than I thought. I definitely think a 5 minute item decay timer might be the way to go. Spam's crap. It's just filth. It's full of fat and yuck. It's just not very good. You know, it's just the hoofs and beaks and lips and cheeks. Is it the same as corned beef? Corned beef, though. I mean, blech. But I used to eat it when I was a kid. I used to get fed it. Ah, right, okay. I need to ask. I was going to ask my dad to get the ornaments and then erg. I am so mad. Isn't that bad though? Kind of personal. Well, you've got to get the ornaments. I wonder what happens if I put redstone on there. Yeah, figured. Okay, never mind. Right, okay. Well, instead of watching paint dry. Them back in the box over there. See what I mean? Where's this? I can hear a zombie. There's something under here. Ah, oh. There's something under here. A cave, sir. Is that it? You've been stuck under here all this time. Oh no. Wait. Is there more? No, that's it. There's nothing. Oh, that poor bloke. Really? He's been stuck in this cave this whole time. Don't know why I'm wasting brick like. I might as well just leave the torches. Yeah, I'll leave the torches. Well, that's one zombie that won't be spawning in there now. He'll spawn in my trap instead. And I'll get his lovely drops. And no one will ever know. Oh, way. What about this? This is why I want this area developed. Need some torches down here. Yeah, I need to get this lit up properly. I mean, that's probably got a spawn point or something. But yeah, I need a building here. I hate all these torches on the floor and all those on there. It's horrible. I need to get a building there, definitely. And I want a melon. I just want to know that it's working. Come on. Bals. Should probably put a couple of hoppers there anyway, just in case they do drop, that's so I know that they're actually doing something. Right. Trying to grow melons. Having no luck right now. Right. Right. Alright, there we go. Six farmers now. So this is something I can do. Right, let's work on this for a bit, okay? Get a bit ore trading done. Now these farmers are level one. So they need leveling up. So we're gonna get our supplies of trades lols. They need a hoe at the end of level one, so I'm gonna get one of them now. I'm gonna get another one of gonna make two hoes. Cause I know they need one at the end of level one. Right. Okay, 16 eggs, 16 mushrooms, some flour, some sugar, some dirt, some hemp, some wool, some bone meal. What was up there? Oh, aye, I moved that to the blacksmith. Some concrete. Actually, they don't need that straight away. Right, some pumpkins. I'm going to need to bring over some more cocoa beans. Right, hi, mate. Let's do some fast trades. Bone meal, dirt, play Amnesia custom stories, not while I'm ill. The main horror game I'm playing at the minute is is Soma. So I'll be going back to that when I'm not coughing and spluttering all over the place. Wow, really? How much dirt are you wanting? Bloody hell. There's your hoe, you filthy animal. Sugar and cocoa beans, that's fine. Right, what do you want? Wool? I got what you need. Ah, no, I don't. Ah, you'd have to do that, didn't you? Ah. I can get it, I can get it. I've got it in stock, mate. You don't go anywhere. I'll be right back. Any seeds? No. Boo hiss. Michaela, I think you are weird. You're seeing weird things. Right, got a stacker in there. I'm going to bring two stacks down. I'm going to bring a stack of that as well. And I'll bring a stack. I can't spare the room. Okay, I should have made some room, never mind. Well, yeah, okay. On average, is that how long it takes, is it? Right. Right, that's good. That's good to know, Turtlewingle. Cheers for that. I'll replace that setup with an item decay timer then. I know melons can grow quicker than that, but I mean, I have got three planters next to the dirt, so there's three chances of a melon to grow. So technically, it should probably grow quicker than that. If you think about it. So, yeah. Ah. There it is. Come on. That's right. Right, okay. 12 cocoa beans. You want cocoa beans and sugar, don't you? So I'll give you the sugar.
apples.
I like kiwi fruits. Kiwi fruits have an incredible amount of vitamin C in them, so I like to eat them. But I eat the skin as well on a kiwi fruit. I love eating the skin. Not many other people eat the skin, but you should because it's awesome. I need more flour as well, so I'm gonna have to. What do I need? Gonna need some more wool. I need cocoa beans and flour. Shove all this back in the box. Right, cocoa beans. And the dirt can go back in there as well. Right. Oh, look at the Enderman. Stealing logs. Cheeky bastard. Right, okay. Cocoa beans. What else did I say? Flour. Right, let's go. We'll harvest the wheat then. Leave the emeralds here. Bring me stuff. Right, and we'll harvest this. Banned who? Who'd you ban? Play the game when it first came out. I was playing Minecraft in beta, like I must say. I know some of the rules in this mod are different though, but I don't think he changed the way melons grow. So, yeah, that's probably still true in this. So, 1.5 days is, that's fair enough. But I mean, yeah, it should grow faster than 1.5 days because I do have 3 melon stalks connected to the 1 dirt block. So, technically, it should grow a lot quicker. What time is it? Oh, the sun's going down soon, okay. Right, before I replant this, before I replant this, I should have enough time. I'm gonna go put it in the millstone to grind up into flour before I before I replant the field. There we go. Right, okay. 45 in each. Right, okay. Away we go. That can be grinding away while I replanted the field. Alright, I didn't see that. Okay, well. Good moderator working. I didn't see it, so. What is the point of posting emotes? Like that many of them? What does it communicate? Absolutely nothing. There's just no point at all. Nonsense is what it is. No, shenanigans, that's what it is. It's shenanigans. Oh, I'm getting some lag now. Like, I'm definitely gonna have to replace that turntable up there. Go all planted. Think it just grows the same? I don't think it would, because it's a each chance it has a random chance to grow. So if you surround it like that with stalks, then each stalk has a chance to grow the melon. I'm pretty sure that increases its growth rate logically. Well, it's definitely not the place to belittle anyone's beliefs. I mean, if you're an atheist, then great. But, you know, don't go around telling everyone that God doesn't exist, God doesn't exist, because, you know, if you want your beliefs respected, and atheism is a belief, whether you believe it or not. In fact, to be honest, atheism is like a religion. It's got a lot of the same hallmarks. It doesn't matter if one person's a Christian and one person isn't. It makes absolutely no difference. It's only when you start forcing your beliefs down other people's throat is when it becomes a problem. Tell you what is a problem though. The lack of melons. No, I am. Right, get the flour. What else I need? Cocoa beans. I'll get them. I've already chopped some down. I ain't gonna chop all them. I ain't gonna chop all the cocoa beans down because I've already chopped some. Cocoa beans, right. They're down here if I remember correctly. I think I put them in the box down here. Oh, by the way, as well. I'll harvest this though, because I could do with the paper to put down in the dungeon. There we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. By the way, I got a sword out of the trap today. And it's knockback 2, looting 3, and smite 5. And it has about 25% durability left on it as well. How about that? That is a hell of a find. That's a lucky drop, that's what that is. So I was pretty chuffed when I found that. That's one of the things you lose when you get a crucible down there. When you get the trap all sorted out and you get a crucible, you lose those rare finds where you get a really good sword or a really good enchanted piece of armor, because you can't enchant that high without going to the end. It's quite a special thing, or quite a rare special thing for them to have. So it's great when they're dropping the trap. I'm missing 2. There we go. Now I'm missing another one. Come on, where is it? There it is. I've made them into blocks, even though I need them in paper, but they're easier to store as blocks, so that's fine. My librarian's on this side, so Wicker can go in there. Right. Well, atheism is like a religion, basically. Yeah, not necessarily a belief, but, you know, you believe that there's no God, so, you know. You don't know there's no God, just like a Christian doesn't know there is a God. It's just a different viewpoint, but it's the same thing. It's literally the same thing. So, you know, you can say it's not a belief, but a lot of people would say that the lack of a belief is a belief in itself, in a way. Just like saying that nothing is technically something, because in order for nothing to truly be nothing, it can't really be nothing. Nothing is still a something. But that's philosophy, so you start talking about all the different things. All the different stuff through that. But yeah, atheism is definitely like a religion. And there's definitely some similarities there. Oh yeah, definitely. Well, I mean, if you're young, generally, you believe what your parents tell you to believe. So you never know, when you get older, you might start to think for yourself. And you might even stop being a Christian, but you might continue to be a Christian. I got a friend who didn't used to be a Christian, and then she became one. It just depends what you personally believe. It's all down to your personal opinions and beliefs. That's all it is. Some people are brought up in a Christian family, and then when they get older, they change, and they become atheists or, you know, theists or agnostics or whatever. And some people don't. It just depends on the person and their experiences. So, yeah. But in the end of the day, it doesn't really matter. Or it shouldn't really matter. So it's fine. else is there? I don't like that topic. That's not something I really want to talk about. I want to talk about how many melons I can get, though. Bloody no seeds. One day this will produce melons. Right, anyway, I'm going to collect the, I'm going to collect. Ooh, I can hear the squids. I'm going to collect some stuff. I don't want to continue with this building until it actually has at least grown some melons. So I'm probably not going to continue with that tonight. That's it done. My beard and my mustache is tickling my nose. So I think I need to trim it. There we go. That's the shit. All that flour. All that nose candy. Oh yeah. Right, okay, let's do a little bit more training with these guys. Bit of that, bit of that, bit of that. Right, there we go. Alright, what do you want? Right, I've got this. I got what you need. Oh. 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 Oh, you can have the balls. There you go. Eggs. Oh, man. No, oh, nose candy. I'm going to rename that to nose candy. Right. Hemp seeds. Mushrooms. Oh, he's almost ready to go at three, this guy. What have we got here? Oh, yeah. Don't want the apples, though. Right, what do you want to go? A millstone. Right, okay. That's fine. I can do that. Sugar. Sugar. I'm getting loads of emeralds here, like. Leveling up farmers is a great source of emeralds. I might consider doing that. Millstones, I mean, 21. The glass. Hey, you know what? Keeping them at level 2 might be an idea, you know. Because it's all the trades are nice and cheap, and they're not. I mean, I'm gonna try this. Ah, well, that's not cheap, but still, that's you know, not the worst thing in the world. Seriously, this is pissing me off. Well, that's a fine trade I can do. Don't mind getting wheat, I'll do that as well as a. Yeah. Yeah, I think I'll level them up. Because it's quite well balanced. Oak wood is quite an expensive trade. All the different kinds of wood can come up, and that's an expensive trade. So I think I'll make the millstone. All I need is some stone and a cog and gear. But that's a full. Oh, brown wool. What's that doing in there? Wow. Okay. That there by mistake. Right. Take this wheat. Feed it to the cows. Take this bread. Used all my glass, did I use all the glass? I must have. Yeah, okay. And the dirt as well. There we go. Right, okay, and how many emeralds have I got in here already? So I've got 35 emeralds now. How about that? Right, I'm gonna get those apples as well. Throw them over there. I do not want them. I'm gonna run this way to see if there's any seeds yet. Come on. Come on! Come on! Put in the sandwich. Steak, I suppose. Three. What's that noise and where is the cave? Why? Where is all the coal? No, I melt down. I thought I melted down more of that. No, melt. That's weird. Right, 4, 8, 12. And 16 stacks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Aye, that'll be enough space in there, I think. Aye, that'll be enough space. Right on, is that. That doesn't even matter. That'll be fine. We'll make some things of that. No problem. Any of my subscribers besides some of us know that I'm live streaming? Yeah, I mean, I announce me live streams on Facebook, Twitter, and Steam, but not everyone's interested in watching Minecraft, so not many people coming to watch it generally. Right. Right, I'm gonna go while it's daytime. I'm gonna go collect those feathers. See how many I got. Might as well go and hatch some more, actually. Fallout 4, I might get Fallout 4. I haven't decided. I still haven't decided yet. I am gonna get it. I just don't know whether to wait for it to become cheaper. I won't pay 40 quid for a game. These chickens are still barking. Well, should we watch these explode? Oh, I can see them a bit there. Chickens are barking, aye? And chickens bark, don't they? No? Dark. I'll wait until morning, I think. Although, I don't know. Do I wait or do I just go home? Oh. They're not even corrupted yet. You'd thought of, they'd have corrupted by now. Oh, they have. One of them has, anyway. Chickens are growling now. No, I didn't. What's 20% off 40 though? 8 quid. Green Man Gaming just the digital downloads, is it? Yeah, but CD keys just I don't trust that. I don't trust that website. I don't think it's legit. I think it's a bit suspect. Because how can they be 24 quid? How do they get it for 24 quid? If you can explain to me how they get it, then yeah. Yes, but how do they get the game for 24 quid? That's what I want to know. How do they get it for 24 quid? How do they get it? How? Oh, there it is. Explosions. Come on. More feathers. Five feathers, is that it? Come on, you can do better than that. Oh, there's a feather up there. Oh no. Damn it. I don't understand. Why 53 lout? I don't get it. I don't watch Max videos, so I wouldn't get the joke. Bye, Michaela. Didn't Steam say they were cracking down on that, though? So, like, you had to be in the region that you bought the code from or something? Oh. Ethan just joined. Oh well, I might get it from that website then. Can you pay with PayPal on that website? Can't believe there's like only seven feathers. There's been about three explosions. What's going on? Like, where's the feathers? Where's all the feathers? The feather lodged in there. Yeah, no, that wouldn't. I wonder if... send you a picture of the game key from the card. Huh. I can't believe the shitty feathers I'm getting out of here. Like, that sucks. Concerned about that down there. Like, tempted to, do I have any glass? There's no glass here. I'll have these back, though. Thank you. Right, daylight's coming, so I'll go. Fair enough. 24 quid though. Jesus. I might do it then. Right. Cool. I'll probably buy it then. 24 quid I can definitely stretch to. Screw you, spider. Oops. Give us a shout and I'll get you a code when you are buying. What do you mean? Oh, you mean you'll get us a 5% off code? Check to see if there's any melons. Damn it, man. Damn it! Damn it, Jim! Oh! Oh, damn it, that was just particles from my feet. Bowels. Hi. Oh, fuck. I've got to press the button. Have I? Oh, hi.
Hello.
How's it going?
That's pretty good. Good.
I'm trying to get these melons to grow.
Yeah, so what's up with the feather popper?
That's too loud. Give it a sec. Right. What the feather thing. That's fine. I wasn't getting many feathers out of it just before, but yeah, it's working fine. But it's me chicken auto feeder I've just built, and it's just I haven't had any melons grow yet, but there should be. I just haven't had any grow. And someone in the chat said that melons take 1.5 Minecraft days to grow, according to the wiki, on average. So it made us think that I might just set up an item decay timer instead of the turntable.
Oh, you done the turntable, eh?
Yeah, I've done the turntable.
Do repeater.
What do you mean?
Well, when it grows, I have redstone pointing at where it would grow, and then like a repeater at where it would grow, and then that would make the block.
Oh.
Yeah, so that you could retract a piston and
yeah,
or whatever, and or sticky piston with dirt.
Ooh.
And then it'll fall down.
Wow, so literally when it grows it pulls.
Yeah.
And only when it grows. Fuck. You're a genius, aye. Yeah, that's good.
About the only thing I'm good at being wolves is working out
so
that
you
crap.
Have, yeah, you have the redstone circuit. So the melon completes the redstone circuit.
Yeah.
Right. Ah, shit. Have to change it again then. Okay. Yeah, that's a very efficient way of doing it. Oh my god, I don't even need anything. I don't need an item decay timer. I just don't need even mechanical power.
Yeah, you just
damn
need repeat a fresh one, whatever.
A redstone torch. A repeater's fine. I've got plenty
of
gold.
Of course. Why did I say repeater?
No, no, you need the repeater.
Yeah, you need a repeater, eh? Yeah.
But I'm just thinking I just need the torch to power the redstone and then... And but yeah, that's easy to do.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah, so...
Oh, actually, Oh, no, wait, you know, you still need a piston and piston tech. Yeah, because... Sorry, ignore me.
Oh, no, I know how it... Oh, I've got repeaters on us, actually.
Actually, Wait.
Hang on.
Damn it, my brain is halfway through a thought and I just can't finish it.
That's fine, I'm just testing it now.
Nah, that won't work.
Yeah, so that right, so aye, there, that works. So when the melon grows, it'll activate the circuit. It works, I've just built it. That's like so easy. Oh, that's great. And that will work with a melon, won't it? I built all that shite. Right, I'm building the circuit now. It works fine. I'm just gonna get a melon to make sure the melon block actually activates it. I'm assuming it does though.
Yeah, you can check that. I haven't tested that either, but I just assumed that would be probably fine.
Yeah. Let's check it. Hi, Mike. You are late. Shame on you, sir. Should work. It does, it works. Great. Well, that's super. The only thing is yeah, I'm gonna have to check it with an actual piston. Right, okay, let's it's a small price to pay, like. But the only thing I'm thinking of is that at the minute I've got the blocks surrounded by three planters, so that it has three chances to grow, etc., etc. I can't do that if I'm using redstone, if you might be using that circuit, because obviously circuit has to go across the thing, but
it's going
to
be less efficient, but it will...
It's going to be less efficient, but still, it's going to be easier on the lag, because I'm getting lag from it. If I do that... Oops. Right, that... And... That... Oh, that's not going to work either. No, okay. So basically that. That's the way it would have to be. Nope. Right, this has to be an inverted circuit. So... That would go there.
Well, you don't have to put it on... like, if you got more than one pumpkin, you can just have it on one and do a whole circuit so all the pumpkins go at once.
True. Yeah,
then
I could
whether
do.
Whether one or whether a bunch of grow on, then it would just pump it down.
Yeah.
That'd be a way of keeping some of the others with more planters around them.
I could use this circuit as a... This is a bio circuit, isn't it? So I could use this instead of an... I've heard of it. It's actually called a bio circuit. And I could use this instead of a item decay timer. So I would never need to replenish this. It would just go on forever and ever.
Yeah, well, I don't need tend to use IMK timers.
No? Well, like pretty good in early game.
Yeah, but you can use like for example, if you're doing seeds, you can use the seed as the item that you're measuring against, so it doesn't really have to be a decay timer. It would just be when the seed gets eaten, it replenishes.
Oh, right, yeah. Oh, hey, that worked perfectly. That worked perfectly. Oh my god, this is awesome. That's
Hold
so
on,
good. And then
I'm gonna turn your stream on so I
you put
can
the
see it
planter,
go.
and you put the planter here. So you can only use one planter, because you've got the piston on one side, the redstone on the other, and then the repeater on the other, and then the fourth side you have the planter. So, yeah. That's all right. But then, yes, I could use this to power every other one, every other piston. So I'd only need one repeater.
Yeah.
Yeah. Not that matters, like, I've got enough gold to build them all, but yeah. That'd be cool. Because if this one grows with one planter, you can pretty much guarantee that by the time this one triggers, the other ones have grown. All four. You
Yeah.
know? Are you playing it?
Yeah, I'm just watching you, I think you're about to put in pumpkin, not too
There.
sure.
Yeah. It's perfect. I just got the delay on the repeater to the maximum, and it just pushes it back at the right time. So that's cool.
Oh yeah, that does look pretty cool.
Yeah. It's cool. All right.
Oh crap, it was dark while I was watching that. Oh, better get inside.
Yep. Right. Well, that's good. I like that. Damn it. Why weren't you on before? Because I built all this. I don't know if you're still watching, but I built all this mechanical power up here to get a turntable up and to spin it around, and all the pistons are pulling these out and stuff. And but it's all right.
Ah, it's all learning stuff, you know, yeah.
Well, exactly. Right. Yeah, I might not be able to fit the circuit. Right. Okay, I'm gonna turn this off. Turn that off. Chop that down. Put that there. That piston is for this one. So, balls. Right, I need to. Right, okay. Hang on. Down there, I had redstone coming in from one side, which could be here. No, this way. I need to repeat out the other side. Is that right? Yeah, I can't have. I'm gonna have to cut down the amount by one as well. At the minute, I've got four potential melons falling down, but this, I'm gonna have to cut that. Yeah, I'm gonna have to cut that down. Because the repeater sticks out the other side and it's kind of over the top of the thing. That's not gonna work. It doesn't work the other way, does it? Where the repeater goes into the side of the thing.
What do you mean?
So if I have the repeater in front of it, the repeater has to come after the block, doesn't it?
No, it can go into it.
Can it? Oops. Oh, it can. Okay.
Oh, that's the primary way I use repeaters, because while it's on, like on the delay, it puts a power on circuit. You know, so you can put four ticks of power on when you run power through it in a tick. If you know what I mean.
Yeah. Alright, so... Right, does that... Oh, well, that means I could still technically have me... things then. Okay, let us think. Right, I'm going to put the piston back here.
And you can use a piston to receive power from the top of it as well.
The top of it?
Yeah, so if you want to, you can use the piston to activate the circuit instead. But again, that's increasing your resources by quite a bit.
Use a piston to activate the circuit?
You have redstone going into where the melon's going to grow, and you just put a piston on top of it that pushes the block to activate the circuit instead.
I don't know what you mean. I'm not sure what you mean.
Well, you know how you used with the repeater next to it before, went to take power out of the block. Use the same thing with a piston. So when the melon grows, the piston will extend, and then you can put some way for the piston to switch on the circuit.
No, I'm not getting it.
Okay. Where's daytime? I can come around and give you a demo if you want.
Well, you can do if you want. I'm just building it like the way I've just thought of now. But you can come across if you want to show us. I just want to get this built and see if it's possible the way it is. That's how it'll go in there. So then that can go that way, but I do need this to be inverted. There, so that would invert. And that is there. Yeah, so that potentially works for both of them. And that's got that melon on there. And bring that circuit around. Will this stretch though? That's the question. Oh, does it need to stretch actually? Oh, it does. It stretches all the way around. Okay. Well, technically it doesn't need to. We could just... Oh, no, it does. Yeah, it does. Oh, no, no, well, if I want to make it more compact, hey Karen. Bluetooth flexible keyboard that you can like roll up. That's cool. Well, that's a rookie mistake, Karen. Haven't you been in bed all day though, you lazy mare? Right, so I could do it like that, and then this has to be still this big, this you know, this bit up here, which is fine, but that's interesting. So basically it means whenever this grows, yeah. I want to wait here and see now. I'm kind of tempted just to end the stream and just go AFK and let it record or something. Because these melons should grow. So let's chat, everybody. In fact, I'm going to go to the toilet. Give us a second. I'll be right back. Alright. I'm back. Excuse the noseness. Now, if it's me mustache tickling me nose, or if it's the cold. Or what? That planter doesn't have. Is that a possibility? Yeah, it doesn't have any, what you call it in it? Any bone meal? Can you make planters without bone meal? You know, planters need bone meal to make. No, need bone meal and dirt.
You need bone meal to make them, but they don't need to have bone meal in them. Once it's consumed, it's...
yeah.
It runs out.
I never noticed that. Can you then add bone meal again to it?
Yeah, just throw bone meal on the ground.
What, to the planter?
Yeah, same with soil as well. You just throw it down.
It just grows, does it? You don't combine it in the crafting grid.
Yeah, you just throw it just like you do with wheat and cows. Aye. It's just
okay. Interesting. Why is that roof glowing yellow? Looks a bit weird. Oh, there's a spy.
So you're out at spawn A.
No, I'm at my place.
Oh yeah, whereabouts are you?
If you look to your right. Go towards me, hemp farm.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Hi, medic.
You're up there where the dirt penis was before.
Yeah. Yeah, this is where I'm building it. Does this have mods? Yeah, this is a mod. And, yeah, it's in the description. What is this? This is terrible. Ah, it's terrible apparently. Alright, so I put the circuit here and I'm just waiting for the melon to grow. I haven't even tested it actually. Let's test it with an artificial melon. Well, oh, that didn't work. Why is that? Oh, is that because that blocks powering these? Hold on, let's, hold on. Oh, is that because that redstone's part? That sucks. Balls! That ain't good. That ain't good at all.
I'll take this chance to show you what I meant with,
Right, okay. What are you gonna do then?
If you can throw me a sticky piston and...
I don't have any. Like... I've just got the ones that are in the ground.
Oh, okay. Got it. Oh, then I can't show you.
Well, we can tear one up. I mean, you know. Tear this far corner one up. Oh. Nah, that's the danger. That's what I've been facing all night.
Yeah, I'll grab it.
It's been annoying. Hat on. This is awful, but you would still like to see what I'm doing. Why, if it's awful? Doesn't make sense. This is awful. I would like to see what you're doing, please. You can see it. Open your eyes. It's right here, right in front of you. It's right there. See? Right there. It's right there. What, you know, what are you... Right, come on then, what's happening?
Okay, so they gotta grow on the dirt thingies there, right?
Are you saying that it would push the... No, that wouldn't work.
That way to get to detect that it's there. You don't actually need the repeater there, you can just use normal redstone. But yeah, the moment it'll grow, it'll,
Right. I think I get what you mean.
It would push the piston out, and then you can use whatever there, like say the redstone for example, to complete a circuit.
Yeah. Right. Okay.
You're not picking up?
I'm not really seeing how I could use that though.
So yeah. Your melon grows there. And then you can use that signal to power whatever.
Yeah, I see it now. Right, so to power the rest of the circuit.
Yeah, so that
so
way
I can use that to power this.
Another side used. Yeah.
So that's there. So I would need to invert the signal though, right?
Yep.
I mean, I'm ill. You have to forgive me.
No,
right there, and so that as well. No, that wouldn't connect. I'd have to do it from the other side. So I'd bring this from here. So this wouldn't be. What I can do is I can put another block on this side, can't I? Because that redstone will also activate. Yeah, okay. Oh, but I'd need to invert this as well. Right there. So that's it would go there, even though there's no piston there. So there... There. Right. Okay, so... When the melon grows underneath this one... I'm gonna go get the melon. Oh, it exploded, didn't it? Of course it did. Okay. I'm gonna go get a melon or two, and we'll see how this works. For realsies. I'm excited. Actually, have I got any in stock? No, I don't. Okay. I suppose it doesn't really matter whether I use melons or pumpkins at this point, does it? So I'll just get a load of them.
Yeah, that way you'll be able to put in your planter back beside it.
Give us a second, hold on. Just catching the chat. I want to see it because I want to know what he is doing. It just doesn't make much sense how because I wanted to see it, but I still think it's awful. Well, you've got no logic. Because you want to know what I'm doing, But it doesn't make much sense. Why does it not make much sense? It makes perfect sense. I mean, you know. Watch. You'll see. You'll see what happens here. When the melon grows... Bosh! Eh? Fucking brilliant, man. Eh? What is it? Does it work? It does work and all. Eh? As the melons going down, they're exploding! Boom! Right, let's see all the melons. All the melons at once. Bosh! Boom! This is brilliant, man. This is so good! Bombs away! And then you go down and collect the seeds. What is more logical than that? Nothing. That's what, nothing. Look at all the seeds, man. Eh?
Good stuff.
Oh, actually, isn't it like, doesn't vanilla not have gravity on the melons?
No, they don't have gravity on the melons.
Right, okay, that's why that guy's wondering then. Doesn't make any sense. It does, actually, because the melons got gravity on them. So, yeah, good, all right, brilliant. Cheers for the help. That's great.
Yeah, so
like, that's
put
brilliant.
That, planter back in where you had the receiver circuit. See, we had a pad.
Oh, yes, I can.
Yeah, that's why I pointed it out
yeah.
Before, when you said that you'd have to lose a spot.
Aye, so this one here, yeah. Put a seed on there. Aye, but I still lose the one planter, but that's no big deal.
Yeah, I mean, overall...
Yeah, overall. Well, it doubles the chance of it to actually have one. Yeah, you fall through there, you know about it. Right, so I need to make another piston, which is obviously fine. And that's beautiful. Beautiful. Ah. This stream hasn't been going for 5 hours, you idiot. It's only been going for 3. Bloody James. Exaggerator. Right. Okay, well, I'm still needed to grow the melon. I want to see it naturally grow. I need a piston, though. Okay, that's fine. Yeah, I'll go and get one of them. I might throw a few hoppers down just so I know that one's grown. Because I'm not going to sit here and wait like a dick. Right, okay. I'll keep them there. Right, and I will get a piston. Okay, I made a load of stuff before, just so I've got it like in stock, ready to go. So like, the other day when we went to the trap, I was like, oh, I don't have any hoppers. Do you have any saws? Oh, I have saws. You make saws, you bring that, blah, blah, blah. So what I've done is... I've just made myself a load of stock, so I've got like 8 saws, 30 screw pumps, 28 turntables, 16 hoppers, 6 bellows, half a stack of gearboxes and a stack of axles, 15 empty planters, 22 full planters, I've got 64 glue, I've got about 3 stacks of tallow, I've got 46 blocks of rope, so like, you know, I'm sorted, so I've just got everything I need, so I don't need to worry about making shit on command. So I'm just going to try and keep that kind of sorted out. So that's nice. It's an arse on when we want to do something on camera and stuff. It's like, right, okay, well, I'll make this. You know, like the other day for the trap. It's like, I'll make this, and then if you make that, then we can do that, and then we can go there and do that. It's like, oh, well, I can't be arsed with this shit. Let's just get it. Let's just be done. So, yeah, that's great. Right, okay, piston. But obviously, I've made pistons. I only had 4 pistons, and I've needed them all, so I need to make some of them now. And the gold is... Obviously, the gold is running a bit lower because I made 29 turntables, so... I'm going to make myself a few pistons now as well.
Yeah, I've been running my gold down, all that gold that I'd stocked up from my mining. Getting all my new stuff put in, but...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, you got a crucible yet or not?
No. I'm actually waiting for a few more cows to grow so that I can kill them, get some glue. I'll make a temporary stalked cauldron so that I can get the glue, make a water wheel, and then actually get the crucible sorted.
That's a good idea. Right, 12 sidings and cobble and iron. Okay, I'm good. Right, sidings 12. Yep. Okay. All right, solar latch. Sidings, iron, cobble. Need more cobble. Of all things, I need more cobble.
Oh, so basically, Unfledged, he wanted some way to feed his chickens automatically, so he made a circuit that through.
What?
Ah, you got some dude talking to you, asking what's going on. He made a circuit that throws watermelons at your chickens that explode, put seeds everywhere, feed them, so they can pop out eggs.
Yeah, basically. I'll show you. There's a second part of this to this system. So you've seen. Oh, it's raining. No, my windmill's off. You've seen that system up there. What happens is the melon. Well, no, I'll show you first. Right, this is. I'll show you what I'm doing. No, this here is a chicken feeder. Is it? Ah, shit. You might want to go back and turn it off.
Yeah, but it's the middle of the night.
What happens is I throw seeds down here. There's chickens in the bottom of there. Right? So I'll throw 32 seeds in because there are 32 chickens on that hotbar, right? So I'll throw them down there. It drops down into a spider's web, which slows it down, makes it go slow. The chickens will all eat it in a second. Give it a second. Give it a second. There you go. The chickens have all eaten them. Now, when they wet in a few minutes, they'll start laying eggs, which will go in here. This is the hopper. And then I can come along and I can collect the eggs. But I have to manually feed them seeds. So every 5 to 10 minutes, I come along here, get the box open, throw 32 seeds down there, and they feed. So I'm building an auto chicken feeder, which is obviously what the title is about. So I'm going to remake that over here. And above it is this mechanism. And this mechanism is an auto melon farm. But what happens is, because the melons are affected by gravity, if you drop a melon from up here, when it hits the ground, it explodes. Oh, there's a melon grown. One of the melons has grown. Oh my god. It's happening. So when you drop a melon from up here, it explodes into seeds. That's what just happened before. So we've made this redstone circuit. So when the melon grows here, it'll activate the circuit and pull the dirt away, and all the melons that have grown up here will drop down. This center block here is where the hopper's going to be, like right down on the bottom though. So when the seeds explode, the chickens will eat all the seeds. And this will happen whenever it grows. That's the idea. And that's how the cookie crumbles. It's not going to be super efficient because the seeds explode and go everywhere. So I'm going to have to encase the area in blocks. So yeah. Yeah. You just did. You asked me your question. You can't ask a question by using another question. Oh, well, good question. Good question. But
very witty.
You know, very witty. But I mean, what? So? What about my life? I mean, you've used your life to come in here on this stream. So well done. Have I? Oh, no, that's right. That pushes out and then it comes back. Aye. Okay, that's fine. That works well.
So yes, the melon maker grows melons, but when the melon, that melon that is by the repeater grows.
When that melon grows, then it activates the circuit. All the melons. It drops all the other melons. All the melons. Oh, I made the piston, but I didn't mix it with slime. I need to put some slime on it. I made 12 pistons. And you don't ever really need a normal piston. You always need a slime piston. So I'm going to, my slimes are all in, They're in the alchemy lab. Well, they are there, but I don't know if I've got some up in my main house. I'm gonna check. Fucking come on, press that button. It's annoying. They would be in the mob box, I'm guessing. But they're not there, so I'm assuming I put them all. I must have put them all in the thing. Yeah, did you get me a message, by the way? I need diamond.
Yeah, I got that.
I need four now because I'm annoyed because I bred one of the villagers and it suffocated. I was fucking pissed off.
Yeah,
so I know I need more. Right, I've only got half a stack of slimes as well, so I'm gonna have to get some more slimes at some point soon.
Again, I'm pretty good for supplying that resource, being that I keep getting a slime for slimes.
Yeah, you're in a swamp, aren't you? So I'll take some slime balls as well. I don't need that many, like, to be fair. I mean, the slimes I'm using now, I haven't gathered any slimes since we first started playing this world. So, you know, a stack would probably do me for a long, long time. Right, okay. 12 slimes, 12 pistons, 12 sticky pistons. Yeah, it is a bit crazy. But if you could see it happening, obviously it's a building in progress. If you could see it built, then you'd understand. But it's like, what's going on here? Why have you got random stalks up in the sky? Doesn't make any sense. But it will. Well, it should. I mean, I've explained it now, so it should make a bit more sense. I mean, James, as James says it, this is purely a way of taking me out of the equation for feeding my chickens. I want my chickens to auto feed, and the chickens eat seeds, and this is an auto seed producer, essentially. So that's what I want. I'm gonna put chickens at the bottom of this, and I'm just waiting for this to grow so that it can come down. I don't know why I'm waiting for it to grow. I know it's gonna work. I just wanted to see it once. I just wanted to see it once. But it's gotten so late now that I can't be asked to build the rest of the building tonight, so I'm going to have to do that over the weekend. But I can take all this mechanical power away now, though. And I do want to try and... I want to see if I can make this smaller. A smaller footprint. Like, I can put blocks over here. And there, like that, so that works. So I can take that layer off. And then same here, so and there. Yeah, so that should still work. Like that, then I can take those off. And I can take that whole back bit off there. Oh god, I'm scared of going through there. I think that means that you... Oh goodness. Oh god, I don't want to step on any of these dirt things, because no, my friggin' luck, it would activate as soon as I step on them. I don't want to take that out, though, to be fair. I want to border around each planter.
We all want to see it, though.
Yeah, I know. It's already happened. I've already fallen through once. Right, so there we go. So I can reduce this as well. Obviously, I'll replace these blocks with something that looks a little bit nicer. And when I build the tower, it'll be well encased and it'll be nice. So it'll not be a problem. but yeah. Right. Oh, he likes it now. It's not shit anymore. Yay.
Now, that was the other guy, wasn't it?
No, this is the same guy. He said, I don't like it. It looks crap. What did he say?
It's probably because he was coming from the whole vanilla Minecraft, which case you wouldn't understand.
What is this? What is this? This is terrible. That was his first comment. Yeah. What is this? This is terrible. Yeah. But no, it's fine. He understands now, so it's good. Hey. That's what it's all about. Okay, so this is great. I'm glad of this now as well because it means that I'm not going to get the lag that I would have gotten. I'm chuffed with that little circuit. I'm going to remember that one actually. So I'm going to take all these down as well because don't need any of this anymore. I will still need the mechanical power for the bottom because I'm going to have the chickens that are sitting on the hopper. I'm going to have that hopper powered so that the eggs pass straight through and they go to a little collection area with about maybe six or seven hoppers, just so I don't have to come and collect it all the time and the eggs don't end up getting wasted. I might as well do that since I'm building an automatic system anyway, so I don't have to keep coming and check it all the time. The eggs will be in there. If I wanted to, I could have built a portal underneath and made a chicken auto hatcher and really do the full automation thing and have it go from beginning to end. So what I would get out of this is feathers, but I don't want a portal in my town, so I'm not doing that, essentially.
By the way, you can take out that repeater and just put in redstone and use if you want to recycle that, because it doesn't need the
Really?
repeater there.
Doesn't need a repeater.
No, what do you call it? Blocks, pistons can suck out power from a block, if that makes any sense.
Yeah, I think yeah. No, you're right. I can see that. Yeah. Working as long as the block itself is powered, doesn't matter if it's powered by a repeater.
Yeah.
I'll use redstone then. Yeah, why not?
Might as well keep it with something else.
Yeah. I'm gonna have to test it now though.
Phew, God, my character's undergoing heaps of lag. I just saw half my hunger bar disappear all at once, and then I got home.
There it is. Fucking works, man. Oh, yes. You just did what? What happened?
Oh, just tons of lag. Like, I managed to get home,
Oh, really?
and then all the hunger bar just went down all at once.
Jesus. Really? Oh, there's an Enderman in there raping me pigs. That's not good. Right. Yeah, I'm good there. Now, and I'm gonna throw them in there. I'm gonna throw all that in there. I'm gonna go to Ethan's place and have a look and see what's going on. Is there anything to see?
Not really. I've got my windmill built,
I'm gonna
but
come
everything
over and have a
else
look
is
anyway.
just it's just crap at the moment.
Screw it, I'm gonna come and have a look anyway. Right. Okay. Mesh make me a statue. What do you mean? Why? It is so the rain gets to them faster. Make me a giant statue of a man standing heroically towards the sun with a plaque saying, "Here stands Ice Mike," and make it out of ice for obvious reasons. That wouldn't work because ice melts in any other biome. Bye, James. Right, where is the, your, did you build a path?
No, not yet.
Oh, right, well, I don't know where it is then. I thought you built a
Yeah.
path.
It's just straight west though, if you want to come, but it's
Yeah, I think I have an idea. I'm just gonna come over, fuck it. Whoa! Okay, that's a big drop. Jesus.
Yeah, there's lots of pitfalls through that desert if you go through it.
No, I'm not even in the desert yet. I'm just in this. Oh, there's a lot of things that need filling up. Is it getting dark? No, it's not. Not quite anyway.
A little clock thing says 3.
Yeah, it does, I. Oh, zombies. There's a workbench out here and a torch. And a great big hole in the ground. And a creeper explosion hole, I think. Right, through the desert.
Yep.
Oh, I think I see you, windmill. Oh, I think I did. No, I didn't. To the swamp.
Yeah, through the swamp. You should be able to see the windmill pretty soon after hitting the swamp.
Right, okay. Oh goodness. Get me shovel on the bar just in case, because I'm worried here. You've gotta make a path through here,
yeah,
like.
No, every time I run through that desert I'm going, this is the day.
Yeah. I mean, I don't mind there's drops. Oh, there's shit. There's all kind of, oh my god, that's ridiculous. There's all kinds of potholes around here.
Yeah, and I keep running through it. I'm getting there.
Oh, that is sick. Yeah, that's sick. Well, I don't mind giving you a hand with a path, like. Path making can be much quicker as a two-man job. One person digs, one person lays, so... Yeah, I'm happy to do that. Oh, I see you, windmill. Oh, yay! You're an aesthetic builder. I think I knew that.
Yeah, well, watching you turn me into one. Before, I was just a build everything in cube builder.
Aye. Yeah, I hate doing that. Yeah, definitely need a path, like. Fuck.
Yeah, ignore the dirt sticking over everything. This thing's gonna be a nice, beautiful tunnel with a perfect
throat. Yeah.
And the stair wall is just for survival while I'm
Yeah, it's good. You stop spiders, isn't it? So
yeah.
That's canny. Oh, you've got a lot of trunks.
Yeah, so this is going to be my login area. I have my have my dock in the water and
the lava farm down there.
There is where my blacksmith will go.
All right, cool. So you're going to make a town, are you?
Oh yeah.
Right. That's cool. It's nice you've got this outdoor area that's completely safe.
Yeah, well that's what I want.
That's quite nice early on.
And I'm slowly expanding the wheat. I'm probably going to cover a lot of the hills and wheat.
Right. Yeah.
Because it's going to be like a big wheat farm.
Aye. Fair enough. That's cunny.
And the windmill at the moment just stocks all my stuff, so it's not a windmill yet. It's full of my stuff.
Right. It's your storage room kind of thing.
Yeah.
Cool. Oh, is it 20 diamond? Jesus.
You can grab some, dude.
You've got it.
There's some clay in this chest here. Yeah. I just left another clay there, so I got something to work with.
What was the trade again?
I don't know. Ooh. Don't worry. I'll just give you what you need, and you decide.
And that's, I think I said 40 blocks for two stacks, did I?
Probably.
I think I did. 40 blocks of clay. So just I'll put two stacks in the mailbox.
And majority of my stuff's still underground.
Is it? Have you been? Yeah. Have you been in the jungle chopping down that jungle, or have you been growing your own? All right, cool. Are you gonna chop the whole jungle down?
Maybe, because I'm probably going to put a little spider thing there too, so that it's eating stuff while I'm working.
That's
so
cool.
There's my chicken hatchery down there, my chicken egg thingy. So it's got
How does that work?
It's got a feeder circuit here.
What's alright, and what? Down here?
Yeah, so so all the eggs pop into them,
and you throw the seeds in the water and they eat them.
I put the seeds in the dispenser block just up here where the switch is. The switch is is a hard off, and it just as they eat it, it pops down more seeds like it just did there.
Ah, right. Okay.
And when it's empty, it just starts. It just continually keeps clicking.
That's good.
Yeah.
Aye, so you don't use an item decay attack, right? Okay.
Same with the cows, except they can't reach the dispenser at the moment, so I'm just breeding them manually until I get enough leather for a straitjacket.
They can't.
And I'll shove them beside the feeder.
Oh, they can't reach the dispenser.
Yeah.
Alright, okay.
So I'm just gonna breed them until I get enough leather, tan it, and then, you know, then make it properly automatic, so...
They can't reach the dispenser.
Yeah, I don't know why. I think maybe they have to be standing up another block, but I don't want to go and put blocks under them.
Does the dispenser spit them down?
Yep.
They spit the weed down? Well, they should be able to eat it. There's no reason why not. Well, that's odd.
Yeah, I know, right? I'm sure if they stood up one more block, they would, but I am not going to risk it, so... I'll wait till I get some straitjackets, kill them all except for two, and... but then later on, this is going to expand into a...
Oh, he's eating it.
Oh, okay.
One of them's eating it, yeah.
Oh, that's nice. But only one of them.
Yeah. Maybe if you took the blocks away from either side, so they can get around it. Then they'd eat it.
Yeah, that might be the thing to do.
But, I think, no, what you should do, is you this 3x3 pit should be around the dispenser, with the dispenser in the middle of the pit, so that all the cows can always eat the wheat.
I guess that the circuit goes off the side, so...
Oh, well, you'd have to have it go off to the bottom. Wouldn't you? You'd have to redesign it.
Yeah, but
You could just hammer out into this wall and redesign a new circuit and lead them through.
Probably this is the temporary area, yeah. Like while I get something permanent build up.
That's not a bad idea. That's a good idea, that, to get the cows to automatically eat their own thing. That's good. Is the hoppers below there, is there?
Yeah, that's because at the moment they're probably just gonna suffocate to death so I catch their drops.
Yeah. Okay.
But the killing circuit is when I'm going to put the water wheel in, so I'll take out the cobble that's there, and that'll leave the one block high jump that only the adults can
right.
jump.
Right, yeah, of course.
They'll come down and get sawed away.
Right, okay. Alright, good, okay.
But it's all a work in progress.
Aye. Cool. Kind of,
yeah. That's about it, isn't it?
Yeah. It's all good. Oh, you could expand this as well, couldn't you?
Yep.
No. Good.
Oh, but yeah, the only thing I've really got is the windmill.
What's down here? Your strip mine.
Oh, yeah, just strip mine. So if you go down to the first level, that's where the cave system that I told you that I found diamonds straight away.
Alright.
So yeah, off the side here, just went straight down, and this cave system goes there. Into
right.
The
cool. Oof.
Yeah.
Oh, some dark bits over there. Okay.
And then, yeah, right down the bottom, strip mine. No.
Can he? Aye. Good, good.
Oh, the basic stuff.
Aye. Yep. I like the little chicken feeder, though. That's, how it's just automatic like that.
Yeah, I like it better than the decay timers where you use the actual
item. I could have just done that with mine. Like have it so. Yeah, it lets.
Yeah, the big problem is that when they eat it before it hits the pressure pad, this way I've got a little bit of extra circuitry behind it.
Alright, okay.
Mine used to be huge, but I saw someone post the builds in the forum and had a pretty really tight circuit for it.
Really?
Diamond arms. Oops. So this is it, and there's a piece of redstone somewhere above there which you can't see. And there's a repeater in there too.
Right.
So see, it keeps flicking at pace they pick up before they hit the pressure point.
Oh, I've just picked up the siege as well.
This is a terrible view of the circuit.
Yeah. Aye, so you what? You've accounted for the possibility of them eating the seed before it hits the pad.
Yeah, that always used to happen to me.
Right.
I'll show
so
you,
how
with the cow one if you want.
Yeah.
How? Sorry.
Yeah.
Oh, I got booted so many times messing with them.
I bet.
That's the circuit. It's really, really nothing.
Right, so what does this do then? Is that repeatedly activating the dispenser?
No, I've turned it off at the moment.
Right.
So I switch it on, on the pressure plate, and basically the repeater guarantees that if it gets picked up before it hits the pad, it'll just keep pulsing.
Ah, okay. Watch out the way then, I'm going to screenshot this shit.
Oh, no, just go into the Bitten Wolves forum and look at the
it's fine.
End of the...
I can just screenshot it. Doesn't matter. Just screenshot it.
Diamond Arms cheap, cheapskate design, which
is exactly
the same as mine, except I just put, like, redstone everywhere. It used, like, 20 redstone. And then I saw him do this, I'm like, oh, God, some people are smart.
I know, some people are smart. Alright, so that's cool. Alright.
And I just flicking on the switch just kills the circuit, and then and then it won't keep popping out.
Cool. Alright. Well, I might well, I don't know. There's no point in doing that with my, I mean, I don't know what to do with mine now. I mean, the thing that's made my auto melon thing. I'm not sure what to do with that because this could potentially make it a bit obsolete in a way, because if I can load everything into a dispenser and just get it to automatically feed them whenever they're hungry, then that kind of does the job, really.
Yeah, this is like early game stuff. Like, all these things you can find in a jungle temple, so.
Yeah. Alright, that's cool. Yeah, because you get them in the jungle temples, even the ones that are thingy, don't you? The ones that are ransacked, you still get the repeater.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, do you? I don't know.
I think you do. I think there's still redstone in the ones that you get. I think there are. I'm not sure. No, that's canny, that, though. It's a good little circuit to remember. And if you can do that with cows, you can make an auto cow slaughterhouse. I mean, that's a good circuit.
Well, that's what this is. Like, so the baby cows go below, and then when they're big enough, they can jump over the edge. And that's when they'll meet the friendly saw.
Aye. Well, could you not alter this circuit slightly? So you could have it so that redstone would lead out of the bottom instead.
Oh, yeah, of course.
Yeah, so you could put this in the center of the room. So they all surround it. Yeah, you could do that, couldn't you?
Yeah. So that would be a good way to sort out, like, one in a paddock. I'll probably actually just build a barn and have this hidden somewhere inside the barn and with a couple cows. So the little cows come out of the barn, mysteriously.
Hi.
Maybe put it beside the water's edge so that, you know, feed the squids.
Hi. That'd be funny. But I'm just thinking of, like, how... So obviously eventually all the cows will jump over without breeding, won't they? So you'd have to have a couple of cows sitting there in breeding harnesses.
Yeah, that's... That
so you at least... Yeah. Maybe, well, I don't know. Would you have them on platforms above, like what I've done?
Yeah,
or would you just have them in the pit with them?
I would dig this, dig away at the hop, where the hoppers are, and they'll go down below their jumping spot. Because that jumping spot's quite a bit below there. I push them up to try and get them close enough to the wheat, but again, they're not taking for some... They probably have to be on their foot, you know, on their feet.
No,
but
I don't... Yeah.
So I don't really want to do that.
No, it
now.
Doesn't.
Don't it?
It doesn't because my, no, because mine they eat it when they're at head level, really. Because I have the spider's web, so the wheat drops through the spider's web, and that's at head level, and it doesn't get down lower than that, I don't think. So I don't know why they're not eating that.
Yeah, we'll work it out with the next iteration. Like, this is underground stuff. I'll start making buildings to replace all this stuff.
Yeah, of course. That's cool, that though. So how do you kill them at the minute?
I haven't decided yet. I was sitting up here with a bow and arrow.
Right. So you could set them on fire.
Yeah, there's that too.
Yeah. Stick a hibachi under there. I suppose. Yeah, you can stick one hibachi or something and then turn that on and burn a few of them at a time. I don't know. Whatever. I like hibachis. I like my little setup that I've got to burn them.
Meat.
Yeah, it is. It's that's a very good side effect as well. I was thinking of adding a little XP collection to it as well, so I can rush water over the top and collect all the XP as well, because it seems a bit of a waste. Add on. Did I come?
Yeah, you went up an extra level. This is the.
Right, okay.
This is where I get to view out and work out what I'm going to design.
Well, I'm going to run on before I before I get started again.
But yeah, so I figure I'll make a temple out of the water, a derelict temple. And that can be the swamp farm.
Yeah, that'd be cool. Definitely need a road, though. That should be top priority.
Yeah, well, that's what I was just starting before I came over.
Aye. You need a shitload of gravel, though.
Oh, I know. I'll probably go... When I go across the desert, I'll use the packed earth if it's got the sandy texture.
Aye. Yeah, you could just use it out of packed. You could just make it out of packed earth, aye. Even on the ground here. I keep forgetting about packed earth. Actually, I was gonna add that texture to it that has the grassy edge. I never got round to it though. It's like a cool CTM grassy edge thing.
Oh yeah, I've seen that.
It's in Conquest.
Ion put it in there, but it never quite matched up to all the colours, so.
Well, I can fix that, like.
And I didn't know enough about it to make it work.
Yeah. I can fix it so, but it would have to have, obviously it would have to be different textures for every biome. But there's only like the main biomes you would do it in. So like there's the snow biome, desert forest. Oh, I suppose there's jungle as well, like and plains. So yeah, I think plains and jungle are the same colours. I mean, obviously I can alter the colours of the different grass. I think plains is close to jungle, and I could probably just make it so they do match, so it would be one extra less thing. But yeah, obviously the forest, the swamp, and you got plains and you've got snow, so you'd have to do a different colour for each one of those. But Ion didn't make the texture.
Yeah, no, he got it from Conquest and
yeah.
Yeah, put it in.
I know, because I've noticed it in Conquest before. Because I saw it and I was like, shit, that's a nice texture. It's a good idea. But it wasn't in the actual... Because there's loads of textures in Conquest that aren't used in Conquest. It's got a lot of unused textures there.
It just uses that the colour overlay system that's in the later versions that isn't in 1.5, so... That's why I wasn't sure how to make it work, because it had the, that funny transparency overlay. Yeah, I don't know.
Alright, okay. I don't really know much about that, because I've never used texture packs later than 1.5, so...
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Yeah, you can. You can crush things to death with pistons, or you can use the saws to kill them. The saws don't destroy the drops, so you can use that. But you don't. I mean, as long as you know what you're doing with the hibachis. I mean, I never lose any drops with the hibachis because I know to press the button 3 times to burn a cow. That's how many times of a button press it does. To kill the cows, because I press it 3 times and then the fire burns them until they're dead, and it doesn't lose any drops. In fact, I'm going to go do it now.
Yeah, so the hibachis don't need to be on all the time. They just little pulse so yeah. The cows catch
alive. Yeah, exactly. I pulse it 3 times. But... Well, like I said, hey, it's science. It's progress. It's technology. I just pulse it 3 times and then that's enough to kill them, so... Obviously they've got them all in there, but if I pulse it, and then it turns off, and then again, and then the fire, it's gone out now, and then the fire that they're on fire, it's enough to kill them all. There you go. Every time, even the baby dies, which is just, you know, ideal. And then obviously all this XP is here, and I'm tempted to kind of, well... run some water through, and I could probably do it looking at the circuitry underneath. Maybe. Maybe not. Yeah, maybe. I could get some water that comes in here. It would spread all around there, and then go out this side. I could do that. So, it's possible. I don't know how much XP this is, though. And whether it's really worth it. It's probably not worth bothering with.
Well, not when you got a mob farm full of XP waiting.
Exactly. That's why it's not really worth it.
Oh, yeah, thanks, Rubikstock. And sure, Ethan, that's what Mitch calls me anyway, so...
Yeah, I call him Ethan. Because, you know, that's what it looks like. Right, there we go. Okay, right, I'll put these 2 stacks of vines in the mailbox. And, if you need any more, just let us know.
Sure. I will do, but I think I'm going to do the path first.
I've got the wrong meat as well. You're going to do what?
I get the path sorted.
Ah, right, yeah, the path is definitely something you should do.
Yeah. But now I've got that path going across the dirt over the river, and that's going to nag at me to finish that to make it look like a you know, river running through a little tunnel.
Yeah, I don't know exactly know what you mean by that, but I mean I'm sure I'll see it when it's finished. So that'll be cool.
Not sure how I'm going to do it since it's on a diagonal either. Like a little a natural land bridge.
Right. Okay. Yeah. I don't like building bridges diagonally. Like, Liquid built the bridge that goes across the hemp farm, and I don't really like it. It's all right. I've accepted it. But when I first saw it, I was like, nah, don't like it.
Yeah,
this.
You just
horrible.
Can't link up things like fences. Yeah, no. Really nicely.
Well, that's what's happened. Like, that's what we've done here. It's like he's linked it up, but he's kind of gone zigzag. Across.
But yeah, the diagonal, that was kind of the perfect spot that the land had available to me at the time. So I suppose we're going to have to see how to make it work.
Yeah.
It might just be like a big hill with an underground river going through it, so...
Yeah.
We'll see.
It could do. Well, I mean, you
pretty
know.
Sure this waterway almost gets back up to the main way, so I might be able to make a boat. Way to get
that'd
boats
cool.
All the way there.
I mean, the rivers are great. So I mean, if you can, I mean, our river is just incredible. It's really good. So you're about there then.
Only thing is getting through the. Getting through the snow biome.
Internet went down there, guys. Sorry about that. I'm logging off soon anyway, so.
Yeah, I'm getting a bit of Wi-Fi grow, so I better.
Yeah.
Better do some work.
Of course. Nah, anyways. Right, well, I think I'll call that an end to the stream, guys. So thanks for joining me tonight. Yeah. I'll see you all soon. I'm starting to cough a bit now as well. I'm going to have a. I'm going to have a lemon sip, I think. Ooh, I've got some nether coal.
Catch ya.
Eh?
Yeah, I'm heading off for now.
Right, no worries. I'll see you later.
Yeah, see ya.
See ya. Get some hoppers. Let me just whack them down where this melon thing is. Just for now, see how many I can collect. That'll do for now, I think. And yeah, that's it. Okay, so cool. All right, thanks for joining me, guys, and I shall see you all good night another time. Bye bye. So ill.